The dark is a scary place. There are all sorts of wild animals lurking here. Leopard, vampire bats, hyenas, wolves, Tasmanian devils, sea cucumbers. And guess who else can see you at night? And I mean, like, really well. Alligators. Down in the midnight swamps of the south, something's on the move. But don't worry, it's only like 2 million alligators?
Alligators are highly adapted to low light and just nasty condition.
For scientists like James Nifong, the alligator's hunting success is all down to its eyes. These creatures have insane night vision. James and his BFF, Dr. Kent, want to know how on earth they do it. So they're using the severed head of a deranged snapper that was formerly a threat to humans to study how its eyes are all the better to eat you with.
So a head from a big nuisance alligator, probably 11 foot. We're gonna dissect the eye.
Ew. Gross. Look away, Grandma. Okay, so Kent dissects the eye. Oh, look at his face. This fruitcake loves it. I'd say don't do this at home, but I'm gonna go and guess your mom doesn't have an alligator head in her kitchen cupboard.
Those are the actual guanine crystals that are separating.
These precious little reflective crystals behind the retina bounce light around the eye. The same crystals are found in sharks and some deep sea fish.
I'm watching you with my eye crystals.
They do, Sharky. I'm reflecting like crazy.
These crystals, it just acts like a mirror, right?
Exactly. It's reflecting all the light that comes through the eye, through the retina, right back through the retina. It's basically as if there's twice as much light there as there really is.
Okay then, rocket ship. So what happens when there's literally no light at all, huh? Like in the murky waters of a swamp.
Grab that gator skull behind you, and we can see there that the skulls are very ornamented in alligators, but you see, especially around the margins here, all these little pits and crevices and canals.
Every one of these holes contains a link to the alligator's nervous system.
Their entire head is covered in sense organs, which create this nerve net around the head, and they can feel any little impulse, any little wave in the water.
So basically, this thing can see everything, and when it can't, it can still feel everything. It's like my dad with his wallet. Seriously.
Hey, get your hands on my damn wallet.
To demonstrate this theory, Vliet needs a live predator.
This black caiman is a South American species with very large eyes. It's actually the largest eyes of any crocodilian.
The incredible eyes of a perfectly developed killer. With the room completely, totally blacked out, an infrared camera reveals them tempting a Philippine crocodile with fresh prey. In these conditions, a human would see nothing at all, and would probably feel a little weird being all in the pitch black in a tank full of fish water.
Oh, she has it. Keyed in right on it as soon as I touched the water.
Basically, guys, you're on the menu of 2 million gators, and there is nowhere you can hide. Okay, actually, it's lucky you're not a fish, turtle, rat, or raccoon, which make up most of the gator's diet. And really, most gators are pretty wary of humans, especially when we wear shoes made out of their skin.
Hey, where did you get those shoes from, dude?
Your mama.
Huh, I'm feeling pretty wary.
Actual attacks are quite rare. In Florida, there's been about 20 fatal attacks in the last 40 years. And the most dangerous animals in the US are actually in your backyard. About 30 Americans a year are killed by pet dogs. And the deadliest animal of all? Bees, which kill over 50 Americans a year. My God!
I'm innocent!